Leah Harris was born in 1985 with a genetic abnormality. She had numerous medical problems that were life-threatening and required constant care. Her first years were prioritised to deal with her basic survival, and health-related issues followed in later years, with maximising Leah's life potential and creating a safe, happy environment for her to enjoy. Leah, now in her 20s, lives in a home which is part of the TICA complex, Transitional Independent Intercollective Accommodation, owned and managed by Sunraysia Residential Services, or SRS. Philosophies behind TICA are based on giving people with special requirements an opportunity to live life to their full potential in an environment that provides creative opportunities for their potential and future dreams to be realised. SRS built the TICA complex for people with a disability because they deserve to live in accommodation as good as, if not better than, the majority of Australians. Not a house with institution-style accommodation that is past its use-by date, with patches and defects, not an institution, but a real home for their whole life in their community. Social get-togethers at the family home are now a highlight for Leah and her family.
She loves being at home, she loves being with the family, but she has a life now that is just so full. And she has friends, she has so much to do during the week that when she comes home it's downtime. And I know she loves spending her time with us, which is great, and we love spending our time with her, but she does get bored. She enjoys going out and doing the things that she sets during the week. We had to change the goalposts. We had to set different lines for where she's going to go. And when she was younger, everything was based on medical things. We thought, yep, to start off with survival, then creating opportunities for her to have the best hearing prospects, you know, hearing aids, eyes checked, speech therapy, endocrinologists, all of the other medical appointments. And then we looked at, yeah, let's have a look at her lifestyle. She's now created a life that she is happy with. And for us, that's just fantastic. Rather than being a person that lives with us and probably would have lived with us until we were in our later years, she now has a life that she's creating for herself, and she's making the decisions for herself.
The change to Leah and her family's quality of life has been dramatic. These changes would not have been possible without the support and services offered at SRS.
We basically spoke with them, and we looked at it very carefully. We, I guess, were at first a little bit uncertain how it may work, how she may actually find it, whether she'd be happy in her life, whether she could cope herself. Leah had been doing a bit of weekend stays where she'd give us a bit of a break. She'd stay with them for the weekend and the respite type care. And that worked very well, and Leah loved it. And so it sort of grew from there. And that helped us with our confidence too.
Leah's family knows only too well the valuable living skills learnt by Leah as a result of the TICA programs.
Well, basically, when I first got told that she was going to move into another house, but, and that she would be mainly living by herself and that there'd be carers but they'd be a few metres away, I was a bit concerned, thinking, how is she going to cope? She's going to get lonely. She loves being around people. How is she going to handle having to have this house to herself and having to look after herself and not having someone there if she needed them? After a while, we go over to her house and she'd just be so proud of everything, and she'd go around and show us this and that, and, oh, look at my trophy that I got the other day. And and she was really happy and proud of herself that she was being so independent and that she could handle what she was doing in that house.
Whenever I see her out, my friends are like, oh, there's Leah. And she'll be with her friends and her carers and she'll be smiling. So I know that everything's okay. And when I introduce her to people, like new friends and things, it's much easier now because she has those social skills to be able to have a conversation with someone and talk about how they're going and things.
Tika is a unique, fully funded Sunraysia community achievement that SRS are very proud to have built without government funding. The design and layout of Tika House offers a spacious, unique setting for individuals to live independently with support, relieving the stress of care that often falls to family members. Tailored to an individual's personal needs, Tika represents the opportunity to learn, develop, and live life to the fullest, aiming for residents to move into the main home when support needs are high, or live in the units with individualised support to suit their needs. The best of both accommodation styles is offered at Tika, with creative training to suit their future directions. The design of Tika comprises of 3 2-bedroom flat style areas under the main roof and 3 single-bedroom units located on the same site. The main home provides accommodation for medium to high support needs consumers with 24-hour support, whilst the units provide permanent accommodation for low needs consumers training to increase their independence in a semi-supported environment. Tika House allows families like Leah's to get on with everyday living and make plans for the future, knowing their precious loved ones are safe, happy, and learning valuable life skills. Families doing what families should, enjoying life.
We're going to say goodbye to Maggie too.